Hey guys, welcome to Crack Java. So in this series of tutorial, I'm covering equal and hashcode methods. So I've already covered the equal and hashcode introductions with the real life examples. So if you have not seen my last couple of video, I will provide the link into the description of this video. So in this video, I'm going to discuss about very important concept, equal and hashcode contract in Java. Okay, so let's get started. Equal and hashcode contract say if two objects are equal, then their hashcode must be equal. So let's say you have a class, a custom class, and you have overridden equal method. So if equal method return true for two objects, then the hashcode function should return same value for the objects. Okay. In other way around, if two objects have same hashcode, they may or may not equals. So we must override both methods while we are using any custom class as a key in HashMap. So to understand this better, let's check this example. This is a class, a bucket class, which I have created in my last video. This has a height and width and a public constructor, parameterized constructor, and I have overridden the equal and hashcode method. Hashcode as well. So I have explained how we can override the hashcode and how we can create a custom implementation of hashcode. And for this implementation, I'm using IDE to generate the hashcode. We can do that. Just right click and select the reflector source, and here select generate hashcode and equal method. So the ID provide better algorithm to generate the hashcode. Okay, to test the contract of equal and hashcode, let's create some objects. Let's say we have a bucket v1 equal to new bucket, and add some values for width and height. Let's create one more object, v2 object. So if we see the equal method will return true when the height and width both value are same, then this function will return true. So for these two objects, it should return true value. Let's test this. So use system.out.println v1.equals b2. Okay, let's check the output. Yeah, it is true. Let's check the hash code as well. Okay, so we can use sysout here. Okay, b1.hashcode. Okay, so now let's print b2.hashcode, run this. It is true, and hashcode is also same. So our first statement is true. If two objects are equal, then their hashcode must be equal. Okay, so which is true. Now to test the second statement, we need to create some dummy test. Okay, so let's say, let's use for loop. We can use for loop for that, and using for loop we can provide some dummy height and width, and we can check if the value of the hash code is same for different dummy values of height and width. Okay, it should be j. The j is less than 50. j++. Here we need to create a bucket instance. So the constructor need to pass the ij as a height and width. Here let's print the hash code. So if this hash code is same for different value of I and j, then we can replicate the height and width. Okay, this is j. Run this. Now from the output we need to check if there is any value exists which have same hash code. Okay, there are many values, many output. Okay, let's check this. We have 998, 995, 992. Yeah, we have two value for 992. As you see, for I0 and J31 we have one hash code 992, and here we have 10 and 992 as well. Okay, so let's replicate this. Here it must be 0. This is 31, this is 1, this is 0. And let's comment this out. Now we can test. Yeah, so as you see, B1 and B2 are not equal because they have different values for height and width, but their hash code is same. Hash code for B1 hash code is 992, B2 hash code is 992. Okay, so now the second statement is proved. We have same hash code, but the objects are not equal. So this function might return the object with same hash code where the objects are not equal. But if this function returns true, it means the hash code must be same for those objects. So that's the contract between equal and hash code, and we must override these two methods when we use object as a key in the collection. So that I will discuss in my next video. I will be covering the HashMap internal implementation and how we can use an equal and hash code as a equal, how we can override equal and hash code for custom objects as a key in HashMap. So see you next video. Bye bye.